Dear Margaret, we are writing you this letter to tell you how grateful we are to have had you in our lives for so many years. You have been a guiding light to both of our boys, Alex and Sean, and of course, a wonderful mother to Juliette. We all love you so much and appreciate what your loving, caring, and spiritual influence has been in all of our lives. You were born on February 6th, 1938, in Rotterdam, Holland. Your mother Gerda and your father Jack Paulus were loving parents to you and your brothers, John and Nick. Your spirituality was instilled in you by your parents and helped you and your family cope with the ravages of World War II. After the war, you and your family immigrated to Australia on a ship sailing across the ocean. You married your husband, Peter Harrop, and your beautiful daughter was born soon after. You named her Juliette, and you considered her your precious gift from God. Soon after, you developed lupus, a disease that attacked your kidneys. Your first transplant didn't take, and you suffered through the loss. I remember you telling me the story about you and Juliette staying at your mother's house. You heard a knock on the window, and it was your husband, Peter. He told you there was another kidney for you, and you had to come quickly to receive the transplant. You didn't want to go through it again, but Peter insisted. "You're coming," he said. And that kidney gave you over 40 years of life. And you were the longest surviving kidney transplant patient in Australia. You celebrated the date you received that kidney every year. You considered it a gift from God and never took it for granted. I met you and your beautiful daughter Juliette on a ship sailing across the Atlantic Ocean. A few years later, we were married in Metung. It was a beautiful wedding at the charming Metung Church. And everybody, including my family, was all there for that special day. Soon came the boys. Alex was first, and you and I were partners, helping Juliette with the birth.
What do you got there, sweetie?
Precious little bundle.
There's trembling.
What's she doing?
They're very good baby. The dearest little face.
We were all overjoyed. And I remember you saying, "This boy is special." Alex was born right here in Bairnsdale. And to this day, he's proud to be able to say, "I was born in Australia." We moved to the States and Sean was born soon after. We couldn't be there for the birth because he decided to come out early. But we both experienced it together by conference call. You were there soon after and spent the first months of his life with him. And you cared for him in your own gentle way, singing to him as you would rock him in your arms. You've been such an important part of our lives ever since we were married. You came to visit us every year and would stay 3 months. We made trips to Australia to visit you as well.
Alex, what are you doing to Nana's hair? Are you being a hairdresser?
Yes.
And do you need those glasses on, do you, to do her hair? Good job, boys. Yeah, very good.
Okay. Oh, yes it is, but I can't show you.
We're all on the boat, and Sean is not so happy. Oh, boy. Woo, Sean is
You have watched the boys grow and become young men. You have witnessed and reveled in their talents and seen them perform in church. On ships. With symphony orchestras. To say you were a proud Nana would be an understatement. You would say, I told you these boys were special, and you would encourage them constantly. You were very close to my mother and father, and we all got along famously. We traveled together and shared many wonderful experiences together as a family. You spent precious time with my mother when she was near her last days, and I'll never forget the gentle, caring, and spiritual way you were with her.
Barbara, I would like to say thank you for being my friend and for knowing you and for spending a day with you recently, which was really special to me. We connected and we talked about our spiritual life, and you were able to reconfirm your confirmation and your faith in Jesus. And I was so pleased to hear that, because You weren't saying much anymore, but you understood everything. And it was a really special time for me, and I'm sure it was for you too. We held hands, we prayed together, and I read to you from your mother's Bible, and you remembered it all. And it was just so lovely to just sit together and talk. And I'll never forget that day, Barbara. And, you know, I always thought you were a great lady, and you love your kids and your grandchildren. We had that in common, and it was just so wonderful to know that you're going to be saved and with Jesus. I'll never forget that day, and I will always remember you with very, very fond memories. Thank you for being my friend.
You and I got along famously. We always had fun together, and I always enjoyed kidding you. We had a special relationship, Margaret, and I'll never forget it. Margaret, you have watched the boys grow, and our family grow as a unit. And the imprint that you have made in our lives is indelible. You left Juliette and the boys these beautiful letters, which I'm sure they will not only cherish, but use as a guiding light in their lives. They are truly a precious gift from you.
To Alex, my wonderful special grandson. Dear Alex, the day you were born was a special day in my life. Your dad and I were with your mom in Bairnsdale Hospital. We were so happy to meet you, and when I saw and held you in my arms, I felt that you were a special boy, and I felt so much love for you, and I knew right away that we would be friends forever. You are 6 years old now, and I am privileged to have been part of your young life. I've seen you grow and develop beautifully. You have a beautiful heart just like your mom, and I think you are artistic as well. You made me wonderful cards and drawings from the age of 3.5, and I cherish them all. I'm also very happy that you have your dad's musical talent. I'm so proud of all that you are doing. I'm so proud of you and that you are doing well at such a young age. The song Amazing Grace is my favorite, and that is the most precious present you could have given me. Your voice is so pure and sublime, I play that song over and over again. It helps me to be strong, and it is healing for me as well. Thankful to God for what he has given me. First of all, he gave me a very caring, wonderful daughter, Juliette, and he also gave me a special son-in-law, Doug, and best of all, two precious boys, Alex and John. God has been good to me. Alex, just remember that I love you and I always will, even after I've left this earth. I will keep on loving you. One day we will meet again and I won't be sick anymore because there is no sickness in heaven. Alex, love God with all your heart and soul, above all things, and pray to Jesus, our Savior, for he is the only one who saves us, so we may have everlasting life with God. Stay on the right road, don't let others influence you, to follow them on the bad road. Be true to yourself and listen to your mom and dad. They love you, and so does Jesus. I'm sorry I had to leave you, darling. I wish you a wonderful and healthy life, and much happiness always. From your Nana, who will love you forever, you are the sunshine of my life. Nana, you've had a huge influence on my life, and you've been a huge role model for me, and you've helped me get closer to God, and you've always filled me with joy and happiness whenever I was down, and I wouldn't be the same person without you. You've taught me so much about kindness and people and how to get right with God and be a good person. Thank you so much, and I love you. And I can't wait to see you again. I'll love you forever.
My wonderful, special, funny grandson. Dear Sean, the day I first met you, you were only about 8 days old. I wasn't there for your birth because you arrived 3 weeks early, but Grandma and Grandpa were there. I was on the phone in Australia, and your dad called me. He was somewhere else in the world, and he was able to connect my phone to his, and together we heard you being born. Your first cry was amazing. I think we were all crying happy tears. The whole family was so thrilled to have a brother for Alex. We were all very worried when you got sick at 10 days old. You were hospitalized twice, and your mom was next to your crib the entire time, in total 10 days, so she could breastfeed you. We all pulled together as a family should and prayed to God for your healing, and God heard our prayers. You got better and came home, and within a couple of weeks, you started to smile that famous smile. Sean, you're the happiest baby I've ever seen. You hardly ever cried, you just made the cutest noises to let mommy know that you needed to be fed. Sean, you made all of us very happy with your cheeky smile, and you're such a funny boy. You always made us laugh. I feel so blessed to have been part of your young life and to see you grow and develop such a personality of your own. You're a special boy, Sean. I love you so much and always will. I'm sorry I had to leave you, darling. Be good and kind and listen to your mom and dad. They love you so much and so does Jesus. Love God with all your heart and soul above all things and he will take care of you. Sean, I wish you a wonderful, happy life with much health and happiness always. From your Nana, who will love you forever. Nana, you've always been a really special part of my life, and I will love you forever.
To my precious daughter, Juliette, even though it may not be time for me to go yet, I want to write this letter just in case. Only God knows the answer, and his will be done. I'm very hopeful about my situation, and I know that you are too, and besides, we have our faith. If things don't go so well for me, I'm hoping that these words will help you a little. From the moment I first saw you and held you, I loved you immensely, and that love only increased and became stronger as you grew up. I was always very proud of you, and whatever you did and achieved was brilliant and outstanding. You were my sunshine, and whatever issues or misunderstandings there were at times, we were always able to resolve them, and you were still always loved by both your dad and I. I could go on, but I just want you to know that I am so very proud of you. For the way you have turned out, you helped me to nurse your dad with all the patience and love anyone could have. But life did not stand still, and you stayed with me and helped me and supported me with my mum and my ill health. I love and admire you for that. Instead of going off with your friends having a good time, you gave your precious young life to me and Nana. Do you understand now when I say my daughter has a pure heart? Don't let anyone ever put you down or tell you otherwise. I'm also aware that you are a good mother to your boys and a loving and supporting wife to your husband. And you have been an amazing daughter-in-law to Barbara and Joe. I think, and so do many of our friends and family, that they are blessed to have you in their lives. However, Doug is a good husband who supports you and the boys, and you are also blessed to have him. Do appreciate each other and all that you have, and be thankful every day. Give thanks to God, for he is good. Again, I thank you for everything you have done for me and your dad and Nana. Don't cry for me when I am gone. Remember, I'm going home, and I'll be waiting for all of you to be reunited. I will love you forever, my precious daughter, Juliette, your loving mother.
Nana, this is a special song for you. We know it was one of your favorites. We all love you.
Love you, Nana.
Thank you.
When you were in declining health and Juliette was getting ready to make the trip to Australia, I spoke to you on the phone. And I'll never forget you telling me, "What do you want me to tell your mother?" I told you to tell her I loved her and I will be seeing her in heaven. You have passed into eternity, but you have left us with an immeasurable gift. An imprint of your soul, a roadmap to follow our lives by. Meanwhile, we know you are watching and still guiding us to be closer to God and more Christ-like in what we do on earth. Although we mourn the loss of you in our lives on earth, we know we'll be seeing you in heaven.
Nana, you've been such a special part of my life, and I'll love you forever.
I'll love you forever, Nana.
We will love you forever, and we will see you in heaven.
I love you, Mom.